Quam.
Jacob Niebuhr.
Reese Jetson.
What's one less person on the face of the earth anyways? Said by the famous serial killer Ted Bundy.
Even in the small towns of Zambroda and Mazeppa, in the course of our lives, each of us will most likely walk past 36 murderers.
Serial killers are able to fascinate and horrify mass populations through the planned killing of innocent people.
Today, we will discuss four famous serial killers. First, Jack the Ripper. Second, the Zodiac Killer. Third, Ted Bundy. And fourth, Jeffrey Dahmer. Jack the Ripper was an unknown serial killer from East London. The nickname Jack the Ripper was given to the killer who was responsible for five gruesome murders in 1888. East London is the more run-down part of the city where crime happens very often. Even though crime is an often occurrence, these murders struck fear into people around the city and society. These murders happened over a period of only 12 weeks in 1888. Stated by Richard Jones, highly acclaimed book and film writer on East London history, presented in Welcome to Jack the Ripper, published in 2007. The first victim of Jack the Ripper was Polly Nichols on August 31st. The second was Annie Chapman on September 8th. The report said her body was horrifically mutilated with her uterus and kidney cut out and taken. The third and fourth victims were killed on the same night, September 30th. The first of that night was Elizabeth. She was found with just her throat sliced and the rest of her body untouched. Later that night, Catherine Eddowes was found, and some believe she interrupted the killing of Elizabeth, and Jack the Ripper killed her for witnessing the murder. The fifth and believed to be final murder victim was Mary Kelly on November 9th. She was found in her room with her body mostly skinned to the bone. According to William Rubenstein, professor of modern history at the University of Wales, noted in The Hunt for Jack the Ripper, published in 2000. Jack the Ripper was thought of killing just those five women, but there are many speculations that he has killed many more people. Jack the Ripper was named the first modern serial killer and was known across the world. Identified by Patricia Cornwell, New York Times bestselling author of three books, wrote in Portrait of a Killer, Jack the Ripper, published in 2002. Jack the Ripper became famous for a few reasons. First was the nickname given to him. Second, where the murders occurred in East London. And third, the amount of news published in newspapers about the murders. After the first gruesome murder, the nickname Jack the Ripper was given to the killer and known by everyone throughout the city. East London is the more rundown part of the city, and the killings define what East London was like. The news about the murders published in newspapers gave daily updates of the investigation and the result of new murders. There were over 100 suspects that police brought in for being thought to be Jack the Ripper. At the start of the investigation, police believed that Jack the Ripper had some medical knowledge or was a local butcher. The killings were not just normal stabbings. Jack the Ripper was known to have a skill with a blade. The police searched for local medical students and investigated local butchers, but the killer was still not found. Jack the Ripper killed five innocent women over the course of 12 weeks. He became very famous and was named the first modern serial killer. Jack the Ripper was never found. Now that we've discussed Jack the Ripper, we'll next discuss the Zodiac Killer.
The Zodiac Killer was an unknown serial killer who was confirmed to have at least killed five people. According to Edward Lazzi, an American publicist, political consultant, and former White House press advance staffer, an article, Dardo the Zodiac, to be questioned by the San Francisco Police Department, published in July 2009, states that in the years 1963 to 1970, the Zodiac Killer had terrorized the people of Northern California, specifically the San Francisco area. The Zodiac was a very confident man, as he left no shortage of leads for the police to follow on. Although he was only confirmed to have at least killed 5 people, he claims to have killed more than 30. In letters he sent to the police, he taunted and boasted of the killings that he had done in gruesome detail and explained that he wouldn't stop. He also added coded messages for the police to decipher. He said that hunting man was more fun than hunting any other animal, because man was the most dangerous animal of all. Imagine having one of your family members killed by this man who had absolutely no regret for what he did, and that he didn't plan on stopping until the police caught him. After his second set of murders in 1969, a man called police claiming responsibility for these murders, giving the location of the crime scene, and told them he wouldn't stop until they caught him. Along with this, he admitted to another set of murders that happened back in 1968. Unfortunately, all communication ceased between the police and the Zodiac in 1974, leaving many questions unanswered. According to Gary L. Stewart, an author that studied at Louisiana State University, in the book Most Dangerous Animal of All, published in May 2014, states that many different people have come forward claiming to have been in relation to this man in some way. Multiple people have claimed this man to be their father. A woman named Deborah Perez announced that a man named Guy Ward Hendrickson was not only her adoptive and long-dead father, but that she had been present at least one of the killings and had even wrote some of the taunting letters sent to the police. Another man named Gary L. Stewart saw a picture of a man on America's Most Wanted who looked identical to his father. This is the only known sketch to have ever been made. This man left him and his mother at a very young age in Louisiana. The main guess by professionals to this day is that the Zodiac ended up dead or in prison for some other reason. Even with all this information and all these different leads, we still don't know what happened to the Zodiac. Some of these questions might be, where is he now, what happened to him, and how many people did he really kill? Now that we've talked about the Zodiac Killer, we will next talk about Ted Bundy.
Ted Bundy was a serial killer and sexual predator who was responsible for at least 28 deaths across the country. The first coast-to-coast killer preyed on young women on the West Coast in Utah, Colorado, and Florida from 1974 to 1978. According to Stephen G. McCod, the author of 9 novels and nominated for the Edgar Award for Best Fact Crime, illustrated in his novel, The Only Living Witness, The True Story of Serial Sex Killer Ted Bundy, in July 1999, that for 7 consecutive months in 1974, Bundy abducted and killed 8 young women around Seattle, Washington. Police in the area did not believe that these disappearances were related until it was too late. The final key to unlocking the mystery behind these disappearances came in mid-July of that year, when 2 young women went missing on the very same day from the very same place. Witnesses saw victims last with a man who called himself Ted and who appeared to be struggling due to an injury that had him in a cast. At this time, there were still no suspects. The bodies of these 8 victims were found at 2 different dump sites, and they were only identified with femur bones, a few skulls, and strands of hair that were not yet decomposed. According to Kathy Ramsland, a professor of forensic psychology at DeSales University in Pennsylvania, and who has contributed 60 books and over 1,000 articles in the criminal justice and forensic psychology fields, described Ted Bundy in the article The Many Sides of Ted Bundy in 2013 as sincere, attractive, bright, and extremely polite towards women. Bundy's girlfriend at the time actually called the police to report him as a possible suspect, but that very description of Bundy got him cleared with the police entirely. Bundy's girlfriend was most suspicious of the sketch that looked strikingly like her boyfriend, the description of the vehicle that sounded just like Ted's brown Volkswagen, and the fact that she had seen crutches in his room, although he'd never been hurt. In the fall of 1974, Bundy decided to leave his longtime home on the Pacific Coast and take his sinister behavior farther south. He was able to continue using his technique of faking an injury to lure nice young women into helping him. He was able to commit three more murders that fall. Melissa Smith, a high school student, went missing and was found 9 days later, naked, raped, and with her throat slit in the remote Wasatch Canyon in Utah. In August 1975, Bundy was arrested for attempting to evade a police officer after suspicious items were found in the back of his vehicle. He was immediately linked to the murders in Utah and positively identified by a victim that he let slip away. He was able to escape his impending trial in Utah and continue murdering women in Colorado. There, he escaped and again continued murdering. Bundy next turned up in Florida on a college campus in 1978. According to John P. Jenkins, a history professor at Baylor University since 1978 and an author of well-distinguished writings on various historical topics, wrote in the article Ted Bundy in November 2017 that he was responsible for the murders of two sorority sisters and the assault of three other students on the Florida State University campus. Before Bundy was caught, he was able to commit one more gruesome murder. 12-year-old Kimberly Leach went missing and was found 2 months later behind a woodshed, with her throat slit and her genitals mutilated. Bundy was only convicted of the three murders that he did in Florida, with no physical evidence against him. He served 11 years on death row before finally being put to death in 1989 by lethal injection. On his death day, he confessed to many murders, but no one will ever really know how many lives ended in his hands. Now that I've explained the murders and manipulative behavior of Ted Bundy, we will now learn about Jeffrey Dahmer, the People Eater.
Jeffrey Dahmer, born May 21st, 1960, was a serial killer and sex offender from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. In his lifetime, he killed 17 men. Jeffrey grew up in an ordinary family. His mother, Joyce, was a teletype machine instructor, and his father, Lionel, was a chemical engineer at Iowa State University. Although Jeffrey came across as a normal child, he began distancing himself from other children and found more enjoyment scrounging the neighborhood for dead animals. With his father as a chemical engineer, Dahmer quickly learned how to mix different chemicals to preserve animals. In high school, Dahmer again started to distance himself from other people and had more disturbing thoughts in his head, like killing other students in spite and raping the boys that hurt and bullied him. This, sadly, was just the beginning of what would become of Jeffrey Dahmer's life. The first person killed by Jeffrey Dahmer was in 1978. A man by the name of Stephen Hicks was hitchhiking on the side of the road and Dahmer picked him up. According to William H.J. Martins, chair of the W. Kahn Institute and member of the Research Council of the International Biographical Center, in the article, Sadism Linked to Loneliness, Psychodynamic Dimensions of the Sadistic Serial Killer Jeffrey Dahmer, published in August of 2011, states that Dahmer's first killing occurred when he was only 18 years old. A handsome boy stripped at the waist was looking for a ride and Dahmer picked him up. Dahmer could not stand to be abandoned and felt an irresistible desire to take complete control of each situation. When the boy wanted to take leave of him, he murdered and sexually abused him. This would not be the end of assaulting young men for Jeffrey Dahmer. After more murders had passed, Dahmer came up with a system of dismembering the bodies, keeping some meat for dinner, and then burning the victims' bodies. One of his last victims was 14-year-old Koneric Sithason, who was found running naked and bleeding outside an apartment complex. The woman that found him called the police and waited until both the police and Dahmer arrived. Dahmer explained to the police that the boy was his adult lover and that he got drunk most nights and ran on the streets like this. The police then escorted Dahmer and the boy back to his apartment, leaving the boy to his eventual death. Dahmer was officially caught four murders later on June 21st, 1991. According to Joe Durden Smith, graduate of Oxford and Haileybury and Imperial Service College and British filmmaker, in the book 100 Most Infamous Criminals, published in 2003, states that inside the apartment of Jeffrey Dahmer were 5 dried and lacquered human skulls, 3 male torsos in a barrel, and a barrel full of acid used to inject with a turkey baster into living human brains. What brings another person to sexually abuse and murder these other human beings is something that only Jeffrey Dahmer will know.
Today, we discuss 4 famous serial killers. First, Jack the Ripper. Second, the Zodiac Killer.
Third, we talked about Ted Bundy. And lastly, we talked about Jeffrey Dahmer.
Serial killers are able to fascinate and horrify mass populations by committing planned murders of innocent people.
Now that we have explored the minds of these horrific killers, we now know that although we are each only one person, one more good person in this world can make an extremely positive impact.